is there any way to tell when God will next reincarnate on earth? Whose question? Whenever a person becomes enlightened, he is the incarnation of God. Any person who is enlightened is incarnation of God. So there is no such thing separately that God will come down on one time and God will not come down in the other time. God is continuously available to the world in the form of enlightened persons. Unless he is available to the world, world cannot survive. What is the purpose to be born on earth? To achieve the bliss, to live the life totally blissfully. What percent of people are self-realized? Whose question it is? Your son. I can say 0%. Because in the world, I think, what is the population of the world?
7 billion.
It means how many crores?
700 crores.
700 crores. Keep it as 7 billion. I can say at the most 70 are enlightened. What ratio you will tell? What percentage can you tell? 0.00000 somewhere, you know, 1 or 2 will come. So I do not know about it. So we can practically we can say it as a 0%. I can say at the most 70% are enlightened. As of now, on the planet Earth, 70 may be there. What is our view of other religions as Hindus? Accept all the religions as one of the branches of the same banyan tree. The same banyan tree exists. There's one banyan tree. There are 10 branches. Just like that, one dharma or one energy, one God. One branch goes left, one branch goes right, one branch goes front, one branch goes backside. So no branch is superior, no branch is inferior. So look at every one of the religion as the one branches of divine. Never look anybody as inferior, never look anybody as superior. Understand, everyone is unique. Is it important to stick to dharma? What do you mean by the word dharma? Whose question? Dharma means, what do you ask by the word dharma?
The moral path, like how you're born into something and you have to fulfill that.
No. Dharma means you are born into this planet Earth. Each one's dharma is to live happily their life, to let others, the people who are around you, to let them live happy, that's all is dharma. There is nothing else called dharma. You have no other dharma. One thing, you should be happy. You should be in ananda. You should let the people around you be in ananda. That's all. That's the only thing, dharma. You have no other dharma. You have no other duty. You have no other responsibility except living happily and let people live happily. What happens after death and reincarnation? Is there a heaven? Whose question? Your question. It is not that after death you go to heaven or hell somewhere. Heaven or hell is not psychological. It's not geographical. Heaven or hell are not geographical. They are psychological. It's not that you go there. The way in which you live only creates, only decides whether you are living in hell or heaven. If you are living with guilt, with stress, with too much of anxiety, worry, the way in which you are living itself is hell. It's not that you go there after your death. You live, you carry it with you. Wherever you go, you create it. You can create your own hell or you can create your own heaven. It's not that after death you go there, there is some place called heaven, there all the people are waiting to receive you. If you do all punya, as soon as you go there, they will do all the respects and take you to the AC suite, nothing like that. So there is no place where to go. It's not like a geographical place. It's more like a psychological. Can you attain salvation without rituals and religion? You can, but very difficult. Can, if you ask me, can I reach my house without car? You can, but very difficult. You have to walk in the rain. What do you want? Rituals and religion is like a traveling inside the car. First thing, you will go very speed and quickly. Second thing, you will have a safety. If you walk to your house, one thing you will not be able to reach quickly. Second thing, there is no safety. So religions and rituals help you to quicken the process of salvation. Whose question? Yours. And then whose? Then, anything else?
I don't know whose question it was, but you said how many people, like enlightened people, well, I don't remember that question. But then, what would you consider Satya Sai Baba? Because I would, like, my parents brought me up to believe that he was a god, but I don't understand.
Why, what is the problem for you to understand?
Because is he really God, or is he like just an enlightened person like you are?
He's also, you see, every enlightened person is a representative of God. He's an enlightened person. Every enlightened person is a representative of God. In his own way, he represents the divine. He represents the God. So every enlightened person is a God. That much if you understand, that is more than enough. He is an enlightened person. So, naturally he represents the divine.
Well, I was thinking about when you said that all evolution happened in India. Mm. And so that, but what about like the Renaissance and other things that happened in different areas? What do you mean like about evolution? When you said that the brain evolved in India, I didn't really understand.
Intelligence of inner science is evolved in India. Outer science evolved only in the Greek. The Greek is the place where the outer science started, outer logic started. Inner science started in Himalayas. So outer science started only in the West. East also had outer science, but too much of energy is spent only in the inner science.
So inner science is kind of like psychological beliefs and stuff like that?
No, beyond psychological. More spiritual. In the here you need a cell phone to speak to the person who is in distance. There you don't need cell phone. Just a mantra, a word, a syllable is enough. You can relate with the guy, wherever he may be. So there are a lot of things related to the inner science started in India. Here you need a flight to fly. There just a carpet is enough. One syllable, one mantra. Two things. West used the light. East used the sound. So it's all related to light. All the scientific development you can see that related to light only. Everything is light energy. In the East, it's all sound energy. That is why just by one carpet they could fly.
You say that humans were put on earth to become blissful. But what was the point of creating humans? Why didn't God just keep us with them and all stay blissful?
Next time when he creates, when he calls for a conference, I will ask him and tell you. There are a few questions which cannot be intellectually explained at all. They can only come into experience which cannot be intellectually explained at all. These are the few questions. Just no intellectual answer. I can give you an answer, but I will not be convinced. You will be convinced, but I will not be convinced. That's why I don't want to give you any answer. Wherever I don't want to give you any answer, I wanted you to think again and again deeply on it. Then you will come upon an answer which totally convinces you, but which you cannot repeat it to others.
Do you think that everyone should be enlightened? Is that your goal?
Yeah. not that everyone should be enlightened. Everyone is enlightened. Only thing you have to understand.
We're not all like you.
No, you have to, it's not that enlightenment means you will become like me, you will put on this khadi cloth and go around Oklahoma City to give discourses to all the kids. No. Enlightened does not mean that you will become a Swami. Enlightened man will become a better person in his own profession. Understand? Once you are enlightened, you will become a better engineer, better doctor, better lawyer. In my life, I became a Swami and I became a better Swami, that's all. Because of enlightenment. Enlightenment does not mean you will also wear a maroon cloth or this orange robe and go around the world giving preaching meditation. No. This is the way it has happened to me. It may happen for you in a different way. Everyone is enlightened.
Basically,
everyone is enlightened. Only 70 have recognized their enlightenment. So I want you to recognize your enlightenment.
Why is it that most of the people that are enlightened today?
Because in India the science is more active and alive. Here, when the kids are born, they are given different type of exposure and the life. In India, different type of life and exposure. If you go through my biographic pictures, you can see me sitting and meditating at the age of 10. My father and mother never opposed. But at your age of 10, you may not have even heard the word meditation. So in India, it's a totally different culture, different exposure, different living style. Even at the age of 5, 6, I started doing puja. So it is totally different. Every day in the house, puja used to happen. So the exposure is different, trend is different, the way in which we are brought up is totally different. That is the reason.
So is meditation like the only way, you said like enlightenment is already in us, is that the only way to like realize it?
Yes.
Meditation?
Meditation is the best way. Puja, they are also way, but they are all, the techniques designed in the Bulakart age. The same Bulakart speed, Bulakart speed. Meditation is a technique designed in the jet age. So, the speed is jet speed. It's up to you to decide.
I just had a doubt about like Hinduism. When we brought up, we are taught two contrasting things, that God is everywhere. At the same time, we all believe in idol worship.
You see, so, God is everywhere, but can you relate to God who is everywhere?
Like, if we just close our eyes and...
One thing, in the cow's body, milk is everywhere. But only when you touch the... Madi Girma Suli? Udder. Only when you touch the udder, you get the milk. If you touch the horn, you won't get... If you touch the... If you squeeze the ear, you won't get the milk.
I'm sorry, Swami, but I don't think milk is everywhere.
No, it's the blood. From blood only milk comes out. The thing which becomes blood is everywhere. It's everywhere. Only when you touch the udder, milk comes out. It's not that in the udder milk is stored. Do you think that in the udder milk is stored? No. No. It is everywhere. The thing which becomes milk is everywhere. It comes out through the udder. So God is everywhere. But only through the idols it is easy to relate to us, relate to the God. It is easy for Him to relate to us and it is easy for us to relate to Him. That's why the idol worship. It's not two contrast things. It's just an understanding.
What's time? You said that the earth will go on forever, but scientifically they say that the sun will like know that and the earth will be destroyed and the solar system will be destroyed. How will that affect
the sun?
The sun will nova or it will explode.
It will release a lot of energy.
Release a lot of energy.
Like, how many years they say?
500 billion.
By the time some other sun will come, don't worry. By the time, other suns will come. It's the same thing. See, from the ancient time immemorial, every time the human planet Earth has faced dangers, human beings have started living even beyond it. At the time of dinosaurs, the temperature and weather was totally different. The whole atmosphere was totally different. But now, the human beings have survived. Even the whole thing has changed, but the human beings have survived. We know the way to survive.
How do we make more joy?
Just because I told you are asking. What makes your life hell? What makes your life disturbed?
Asking for more greed and I guess analyzing things all the time.
Then?
Competition. Mm. Comparison. Mm.
Drop from all these things, that's all.
But it's not easy.
Why do you say it's not easy?
I guess because everybody around you thinks the same way and you're brought up in a society which
one is thing, so when you understand the fire burns your hand, why can't you take it away?
Try.
No. Can you say, I know fire burns, but I can't take it away, take away my hands?
That's more physical, but this is more mental.
Ah. How much you understand physical things, that much you don't understand psychological things. That much importance you don't give for psychological injuries. That much of importance you don't give to look into yourself. I tell you, give your own time, give a little bit of time to look into yourself, have appointment with yourself. You give appointment to everybody, but you forget to give appointment to yourself. The appointment to yourself only, I call it as meditation. So understand very clearly that this is the thing which burns, this is the thing which disturbs, this is the thing which makes your life hell. And look into it deeply and give importance to psychological injuries and make your life happy, that's all. It's a very simple intelligence. You learn all these words. I tried, but I'm not able to be successful, Swamiji. All these words you try from your elders, you learn from your elders. You never tried. Just you get the conclusions from elders. Never you get techniques from elders. You take conclusions from the elders. Never do that. Try on your own. Everything. Try to analyze all the data which you collect from your elders. Never take any data as it is just because it is told to you. Analyze every data. Then you will surely come upon a new way of living. In your own way. Your understanding should become your life. Not somebody else's understanding. Time is up. Okay, so all my love and blessings. Thank you.